Are you taking it?
Ooh, look at this senior.
You already caught it at the.
You feel me, like?
everyone, I said congratulations. And these were making my shit bleed so hard.
When?
When your mom came over.
That was not funny.
Meal before the game for real noodles. Noodles, not noodles.
Oh yeah, I'm ready for the interview.
My name is Lucas Bochung. I'm a senior graduating this year. I started volleyball in my junior year. First, it was in the summer of junior year before the season started. And I played with my church people, with some friends. And then it just really went from there. Shut the hell up, damn. Go downstairs or something.
Bruh.
I started setting and like took that position on because Gid was a hitter. And Van Van took the role of being the libero. So I took the role of being the setter. I trained, but I really didn't have the setter hands, you know. So it really took a while for me to get good at it. I did academy over the summer. I was a setter there. I ran 5-1 with my team. And I played, the first season I played junior year, I played setter. And we ran a 6-2 with Ryan Beach. And now over the summer, last summer, I was practicing setting only. Now I can do jump sets and my sets are not looking nice and the hands are good. But I was told we needed a libero. And last season I told coach I'll be able to be. But then I realized I did not really enjoy the libero position. So I told her I couldn't. But at the end of the day, you know, it is what it is. I had to take that role on for the team. And team over selfishness, you know.
It's 5:11. We were supposed to be there at 5.
Someone dropped their keys.
Oh, shoot.
All right, hey. Come on, Sabina.
Where's Kitty? Kitty. It's 5:26. Teammate called, I guess, because we're late. So I'm like, I gotta stay dripped up before the game starts, you know. Oh shit, man, what the hell, boy? Like, you're gonna catch that.
We're at the home of the Trojans, aka the belly of the beast. We're late as hell. Hope coach don't get on our ass.
There he is, bro.
Oh, you showed up.
Dude, oh my gosh.
What?
Because you want pictures, bro.
Jackpot.
Oh, they're shooting. Nah, I'm just gonna do it for the game.
No, wait. I didn't wear my tie, no way.
Yeah, see?
Let's get these pictures real quick so we can change it out.
Was this for you?
Yeah. I was gonna make one for Brennan. You can sell this for a lot when I'm famous.
Of course.
Look, that's Alex. Hey, pitch inside.
Where we get it? Where we go?
Infinity sign. Lucas Bochung.
Woo! Superman.
Come here, bro. We gotta introduce you guys to the manager. And Brennan.
It's my baby.
The managers.
Okay.
Get in the camera. Introduce yourself.
Sierra.
Okay, but like,
you're great. I don't know. I'm a sophomore. I joined because I'm super cool. They're cool.
Okay. Next.
My name is Gia Tezio. I'm a sophomore. I joined because my brother made me.
Yeah. Because our brother made her. Rachel.
My name's Rachel Buckholz. I'm a senior. I joined on a whim, trying to I wanted to announce games and get over my anxiety over like socializing. So this worked pretty well.
All right. Okay. Then we got Megan.
My name's Megan Miniman. I'm a junior, and I joined because Coach Pollock asked me to.
Yeah. Hey, we're gonna meet Brennan. Come here. This is Brennan, the one and only CGVB fan page runner. What do you have to say? Like, introduce yourself. They don't know you yet.
Hey, my name is Brennan McDougall. I'm 18. I'm a senior here. I'm going to say this right now. I never thought one random night, right?
Mm-hmm.
My buddy tells me to come to a CG volleyball game. And I was like, all right, I'll go. But I never thought
game,
I'd...
Right?
It was the Perry game.
Yeah.
I never thought I'd like it this much. But this became one of my favorite things I like to do. These guys are awesome, every single one of these guys on the team. It's been a heck of a season, but it's not done yet.
Hey, tell them what you're about to do.
Yeah, tonight I'm going to be announcing the seniors.
Uh-huh.
This is kind of a, if you guys don't know this jacket is very special to me.
OG.
You know, but hopefully a bunch of the CGVB fans show out tonight. We're missing a couple. Shout out to Katie Adams.
Uh-huh.
Nolan Howard, gonna shout you out as well, buddy. But yeah, top two, not two.
Have fun announcing, bro. Good luck with that.
Hey, back in blood.
Back in blood. Hey, top two, not two. Did it really good. Brennan got something to say. No, he got something to do.
No, these hallways. I'm gonna miss them when I graduate, man. It holds a lot of memories, a lot of ups and downs. Well, who the hell are you? Cafe, you know, bathroom right here. The bathroom where all the kids do drugs. That's it, man, because I'm Christian. You feel me? Can we stop?
Yeah, she came with it.
Dude, that's the deal with my mama.
Stop playing with him, bro. Stop playing with him. The cowboy. Hey, come here.
I got my wallet in my boots because I don't got no pockets.
Hey, come here. You guys
made it. JV's going right now. Second set, so now it's 1-1.
Hey, game over. No one else going? It's Dahl. Say hi to the vlog, bro.
What's up? Hey. CG about to win 3-0.
So be other than. Climb the damn stairs, bro. Is the homeboy Jonathan? Is the G or any of them coming? No? Wow, fake friends.
Now for number 8, Lucas Bochung. Let him do this. Next year, Lucas plans to attend Wabash College. Lucas says his favorite volleyball memory is the CGVB fans coming to our games and cheering us on. His favorite high school memory would be the times he forced himself to talk to people because he was tired of being shy. Message to seniors, thank you guys, top two, not two. Let's go.
So emotional, so inspirational. Yeah. Got the ball on. Do it. Do what you're gonna do.
Yeah, we need to warm up.
Talk to you.
I'm stressed.
This is a documentary. You should get like a solid 10 seconds of just like a close up of my face.
Of you?
Just like, no, like just, yeah.
I think it's time to quit. I cannot deal with all this shit. I am irrelevant. You made me mental, now I'm pissed. I'm like super bad. I try to leave, but now I'm sick. Now I know I'm on my own, so I can never trust no bitch. You can find me.
He's the biggest factory he has.
Passing. He's, you know, he's libero. I've seen him set. He's a good setter, but like,
he really helped pass, clean up all the tips and everything. But yeah.
How do you think he's affected the whole team's game plan?
I think he's affected it by bringing it up. Like, his passing in the back row really helps our serve receive, our free ball passing, and just overall. Like, he knows where to go, he knows what to do, and it just really helps the overall ball control on the team. He also just, like, helps us to get our spirits up, and just is really a positive effect on the team. Oh yeah, for sure. He's when I'm watching him, I can see where I have to position myself. He's taught me a lot of things in practice and stuff like that.
How would you describe his overall gameplay skills?
He's a very, very scrappy player, which is a good thing. He doesn't miss very many balls. He doesn't let the balls hit the ground. You'll never see that from him. And just very good overall.
The best thing about Center Grove would be the servings. The team as a whole has a lot of aces, and also the blocks. We have 6 foot and up at the front row, knocks out court, and we got blocks down. Our middle, Jack, he's really good at blocking. But our best blocker, I have to say, is Bo. He gets the hard hitters, the outside harders of the other teams, and he locks them down, he tracks them, does really well. That's my brother Joshua.
But they're not, so like bring it in a little bit.
Okay. And
Shots on three! 1, 2, 3, shots! Back in front! We out here winning. That's all I can say.
My name is Ryan Beach, setter and right side. You know, the big left hand on the team. Basically what I do.
You've been playing with Lucas for 2 seasons.
For sure.
How do you think he's like affected the group's gameplay, everything?
Well, I mean, he's the shortest on the team, so you know. He's like the best libero on the team. He had to play libero. He didn't want to play libero this year, but you know, like, he had to for the team. He's made the team better. You know, that's what it's all about. I learned his username, Instagram, letter from Lucas, the best nickname of all time. But I've learned that you can get any ball up. Chose and you chose the road. It's all that we've been through. Since you love and got no one to vent to. I don't mind. I never wanna say goodbye.
Before the season started, I didn't really see the point of volleyball, playing volleyball, really, because I wasn't planning to do it on college level or anything like that. And it just took a lot of my time, so I just thought I should quit and, you know, focus on something else that would actually invest in my future and whatnot. But when season did start and coach told me to be libero and just said I needed to be one, I told her I would rather quit. And then she just didn't like that very much, and just, we didn't talk for a little bit. But then after practice was done, she came up to me. She explained to me the situation Center Grove was in and how she would, you know, put me as a setter, like, when the time comes. But, like, as of now, we really needed a libero, since our last libero, who was really good, graduated, and there was no other player that could take on that role. And so I just had to take the role on myself and just focus on getting better at the libero position, even though it's new to me.
All right, what's the last thing you want to say to the audience?
Message for the audience, you know, if I do, you know, do college volleyball or not, it's still a mystery, but I really do hope to be able to play in that higher level. And if not, then it's fine. I'll focus on other things. Volleyball isn't my first priority. Yeah, that's not a conflict. Let me call, let it go, condition. Tryna get on the road, do some shows, you know what I'm missing. Let's just die, but I'm tripping over the odds, that's the vision. Baby, my pride got me slipped, my heart's so tired, need some fix. Can't go back to the old me, I'm better on my own. No, you cannot call me, you ain't do the wrong. But you left me the away, yeah, you left me the away.
I didn't play that much.
Beginning, I kind of fumbled a little bit, like didn't move my feet much, and I didn't really have control over the back row, but you know, as the game went on, I got more into my rhythm and I was making good saves. I think 1 to 10, I played 8.5, close to 9.
So it was just like one of the better games you've played?
Yeah, I think one of the most like reasons why I played good today was just having the crowd there, screaming my name, and like knowing that there's people watching me. But like I did miss a few serves though because of the shit, boy.